Hello, everyone, and welcome to this edition of Race Face Driver Updates. I'm Brittany Lung. Let's get started with our Race Face drivers. Sheldon Creed was at Canadian Tire Motorsports Park yesterday as the NASCAR Gander Outdoor Truck Series took to the 2.5-mile, 10-turn road course. Sheldon did not have the qualifying run that he had hoped for and had to start 17th on the field, but quickly made his move into the top 10 and ran there most of the race, eventually coming home in fourth place, his sixth top 10 finish in the last 10 starts. Up next for Sheldon, Las Vegas Motor Speedway on September 13th. Sam Mayer saw action Saturday night at Worldwide Technology Raceway at Gateway in Madison, Illinois, in the NASCAR K&N Pro Series in an East-West combined race. Sam qualified fourth in his number 21 GMS Chevrolet for the scheduled 125-lap event, running on the same night as IndyCars. Sam led 28 laps in the race and had the fastest car, but on a late race restart, he got passed, then got loose on the final lap coming to the checkers and finished fourth. Now here's the weird thing. The race only ran 98 of the scheduled 125 laps. We were told this race was shortened because of time. Can't quite figure that one out. Up next for Sam, ARCA Racing Series on September 14th at Salem Speedway. Jesse Love returned to Jacksonville Speedway in his number 97K Keith Coons Power Eye National Midget, where he finished third in his heat and fourth in the feature. Up next for Jesse, Power Eye National Midgets at Lake Ozark Speedway in Eldon, Missouri on August 31st. Adam Lemke was back at Orange County Speedway for the Cars Tour 100-lap Mid-Atlantic Classic on Saturday night. Mother Nature played havoc on the competitors, resulting in a very limited practice on both Friday and Saturday. Adam qualified 16th and had a great run going, running as high as third in a race marred with cautions. Adam took the white flag in sixth, but was hit by another car, spinning him out in turn one, resulting in a 13th place finish. Up next for Adam, Cars Tour at South Boston Speedway on November 2nd. Minnie Tyrell was also at Orange County Speedway on Saturday for the Cars Tour race, but before the race started, was awarded a $500 check for winning the best throwback paint scheme for his Rainbow Warrior entry for the Throwback 276 at Hickory last week. This young man has the biggest heart, as he donated the $500 to the Jeff Gordon Children's Foundation. You are a class act, Minnie. Now on to the race. Minnie qualified fifth, his second top five starting position of the year, but was caught up in a lap three incident when Josh Berry had what we thought was a blown engine oiling down the track, resulting in several cars ending up in the wall. Minnie made it through, but suffered damage to both the front and rear end of the number 81 Friends of Jacqueline Chevrolet. Minnie fought hard and ended the night with an 11th place finish. Up next for Minnie, South Boston Speedway on November 2nd. Brian Henderson was at Virginia International Raceway in his Speedworks Friends of Jacqueline Honda for the IMSA Michelin Pilot Challenge Series. Mother Nature forced the cancellation of qualifying on Friday, so the field was set by points. Brian rolled off fifth and was running as high as third before they had air jack issues during a pit stop that put them three laps down, eventually finishing 11th. Up next for Brian, WeatherTech Raceway Laguna Seca in Monterey, California on September 14th. Connor Mosack returned to Hickory Motor Speedway for twin 40-lap races in the NASCAR Wheel and All-American Late Model Series. In race one, Connor finished sixth, and in race two, brought home a 9th place finish in his number 18 Nick Taylor Friends of Jacqueline Late Model. Up next for Connor, back to Hickory on August 31st. Joey East was at Madeira Speedway for round 7 of the 5150 Junior Late Model Series, where he qualified second. Joey took the lead early and led 67 of the 70 laps, bringing home his third win in a row and fourth of the year in 7 starts. Joey has not finished outside of the top 3 all year and continues to lead the points with 2 races remaining. Joey also ran the NutUp Pro Late Model race where he qualified 12th, ran up to 6th, but was involved in an incident and then sent to the back. Then on lap 65, he was caught up in someone else's mess and decided to park it for the night, being scored 19th. Up next for Joey, Focus Midgets at Stockton 99 Speedway on August 31st. Joe Valento went up to Elko Speedway to support NASCAR Kid and Tribute Night. He did decide to take his legend car up and have a little fun, but didn't know he was there to receive the 2019 Sportsmanship Award from the Jeremy Johnson family. Jeremy was killed by a drunk driver 16 years ago. Joe received this award for not only his sportsmanship at the track, but also his involvement with the Friends of Jacqueline Foundation. Congratulations, Joe. All of us here at Race Face are so proud of you. Now let's check in on the Race Face Next drivers. Jake Bowman also saw action at Madeira Speedway in the 5150 Junior Late Model race, where he qualified 7th, drove up to the 5th place position at the halfway break, and then brought home the number 38 Nate Clower Toyota in 7th place. Up next for Jake, back in the legend car at Las Vegas on both Friday and Saturday night. The Red Army was back in action at El Paso County Raceway for some non-winged 600 micro sprint action in the Mile High Now 600 series. Let's first check in on Justice Sokol. You might not know, but Justice is the youngest driver competing in most of these races, and normally the only driver running a restricted motor against the non-restricted cars. On Saturday, Lawman finished 5th in his heat race, started 15th in the feature, and finished 11th. Older brother Colby Sokol finished 2nd in his heat, started 5th in the feature, and brought home a 5th place finish. Up next for the Red Army I-76 Speedway in Fort Morgan, Colorado, this Saturday. Cassidy Hines is at Colorado National Speedway, making her 2nd start in the Pro Truck Series in her number 3 Friends of Jacqueline Chevrolet. Cassidy took the green flag from the 13th starting position and raced her way to a top 10 finish, taking the checkers in 8th position. Up next for Cassidy, back to the dirt in her 600 micro sprint at I-76 Speedway this Saturday. Wilcox was scheduled for double duty in the INEX Legend car, but Friday's race at Anderson Speedway was rained out. On Saturday, Will and his Farbo team made the trip to Atlanta Motor Speedway, where he took the green flag from the 4th starting position, raced his way to the lead. Will led a lot of laps, but got passed in the closing laps and finished 2nd. Race Face drivers who didn't compete last week but will see action this week include Joe Valento, who returns to the Midwest Truck Series at Dells Raceway Park on Saturday. Bryce Bezanson will be at Evergreen Speedway in his NASCAR Whelen All-American Series late model. Big announcement this Friday as we reveal the Junior Late Model Challenge Camp winner. The camp winner will compete in the Championship Weekend Junior Late Model race at Madeira Speedway on October 5th. That's it for this week's Race Face Driver Updates. And remember, if you've missed any of our shows, you can get caught up on raceface.tv on demand. Don't miss Race Face Spotlight on Thursday at 10 o'clock Eastern Standard Time, this week featuring NASCAR Gander Outdoor Truck Series driver Anthony Alfredo. As always, we encourage you to support local racing in your communities. Don't forget to follow us on social media. We will be back next week with more from your favorite Race Face drivers. So go out there, have a great race week. I'm Brittany Lung. Thank you for watching.